Surveyor 2.0 uses a different approach to how the tools are used compared to Classic Surveyor. Classic Surveyor had separate tabs for different object types. Each of these tabs had duplicate functionality, like Add, Rotate, or Delete. S20 removes this segmentation and duplication by making the one tool work on multiple object types. This simplifies the UI down to a handful of tools needed to complete most tasks. While this video doesn't go into fine detail on each of these tools, it does give you a brief overview of the tools palette. The first tool is the brush tool. This is a paint tool. From this single tool, using the first drop-down option, you can paint the ground, change terrain height, paint water effect layers, clutter effect layers, and paint scrapbooks. The second drop-down option is a subset of options that complement the first drop-down. For example, height up, height down, set height, and grade are all different functions of the ground height. You will notice there are tool options as well. While we will cover these in a separate video, you should know that the tool options that have their icon enabled or highlighted are the tool options that are currently active for the current tool you have selected. If the tool option icon is not highlighted, then it will have no effect on the tool configuration you are using. The placement tool allows you to add any type of object. Search for an asset in the asset palette. When you find what you're looking for, left-click the asset and the placement tool will be enabled to allow you to start placing down one or more of the assets you have selected. Next is the eyedropper tool. You can use this tool to pick an asset in the world and find it in the asset listing. If you use the eyedropper tool on a ground location, not only will the ground texture show in the asset listing, but it will also update the tool options based on the current configuration of that ground texture at that terrain location. This makes it very easy to continue making similar edits in the world with the same asset. Having the eyedropper tool get the height on the terrain location is also handy when making further terrain height adjustments. The free move tool is very similar to the move tool in Classic Surveyor. Hover over an asset in the world, hold down the left mouse button, and drag to move it. The fine placement tool gives you more control over movement and rotation along individual axes if you need it. The Marquee tool is a multifunction tool that can be used to perform several different operations. Selection, copy to create a scrapbook asset, paste, which pastes the scrapbook asset within the Marquee area, terrain manipulation, from ground texture bulk fill, adding baseboards, deleting baseboards, and more, which is covered in another S20 video. You can perform move and rotation operations on the selected area using the Marquee tool. There will be a separate S20 shortcut keys video coming soon. But one handy shortcut key you might like to know about when using the Marquee tool is Ctrl D, which deselects the current Marquee selection. That's a brief overview of the tools palette, but be sure to search on each tool individually on our Surveyor 2.0 channel, as each tool in the tools palette will get its own S20 detailed video explaining all the functionality available for that specific tool.